It's no surprise that the market hasn't been doing very great. In years prior, we've had our fair share of dips and slow markets, but considering the recent update size with regard to the current player counts and prices, things look like they're slowing down. Welcome back to another video, my name is Nalo, and we're going to be taking a look at the market today. But before we get into that, a quick word from my sponsor, ShadowPay. ShadowPay is a huge CSGO marketplace with any skin you can possibly think of. They have great discounts that are much cheaper than the Steam Community Market. They're fast, easy to use, and they have a secure extension for player-to-player trades, or if you don't want to wait for that, you can always use their instant sell feature to instantly get cash for your skins. If you do want to buy the dip, ShadowPay's huge inventory is a place you should look first. And if you use my promo code NALO, you'll be able to get a 2% deposit bonus on the site. If you want to check out ShadowPay, please use the link in the description below. Thanks. The CSGO market is down. No one can argue against that, and given the effort we've seen from Valve's end recently with an insane major, arguably one of the best operations in the game, and even the cherry on top, an upcoming case utilizing relatively new design mechanics in a way we haven't seen before. With all of this in mind, the player count numbers just simply don't add up. It's clear there's declining interest, either from competitors or potentially people leaving their demonetization dens, but at the end of the day, the market is suffering as a result. The question is this a dip? Will we see a resurgence in the market, or are we on a death march? To answer this question, I would first like to direct your attention to some future events that could potentially bring an upswing. The first is Christmas and the preceding winter time into February. This is historically a very good time for the CSGO market due to more wealth as a result of Christmas gifting and more vacation time for many people. This event, so to speak, could be the key to more price raises and more hype, but we don't truly know until it happens since the dip itself is already exhibiting some strange and new qualities. The second upcoming event that could cause an uptick is the Chinese New Year. This is historically a great time to own high-tier CSGO items, as with Christmas, there's more vacation time and wealth, only this time primarily in the Asian community. Once again, this could be something that brings the market up, but we won't know until we get there. After that, the next event isn't until summertime, where we've seen rampant price manipulation and hype drive the market sky high for the last 2 years. In my personal opinion, I don't think Christmas or Chinese New Year will be large enough to counteract the bleeding interest, but they could definitely stabilize things and create a base for the market to build on. This could mean that summertime, provided there is another wave of manipulation, will be the figurative phoenix out of the ashes for the market. So, do you buy into this dip of sorts? The answer is kinda. Your success is going to depend heavily on what you buy and for how long you hold it. If you're planning to go all the way to summer, you'll likely benefit the most from mid-year tournament stickers and liquids. If you're planning to go to Chinese New Year, high tiers would hypothetically be your best friend. And if you're planning for Christmas, you'll want to stick with liquids to make a small profit on, provided there's room for it. You don't want to buy into everything, but buying into nothing could also be a missed opportunity. As with anything market-related, there's going to be risk involved, so you'll have to decide for yourself if it's worth taking on that risk for the upcoming events. There's also the topic of Operation Skins. We got a lot of new ones and a lot of beloved high tiers, like the Op Hydra and the Gold AK, that I'm not going to attempt to pronounce. These could be stellar options for the Chinese New Year, provided there's enough interest in them. If you're interested in this play, stick with pinks and reds from the newer collections. The new major stickers are another topic. Like RMR, they've gone on sale to 25 cents per capsule, and although these stickers arguably look a lot better than RMR, the investment result will unfortunately probably be the same. I would avoid these. As for liquids to buy, as always, AK Redlines and Op Asimovs are always a solid choice. Newer liquids like the Deagle Printstream and the AK Slate could also end up being solid choices come Christmas. The general rule to liquid is to think of skins that are nearly universally known in the community and are used by players as play skins at high rates. If we're waiting all the way to the summertime for this uptick to occur, there could be another issue entirely. It's important that there's a consistent level of hype that occurs throughout the year, and so if we're waiting all of these months until the summertime for this hype to occur, then that could cause the summertime to not have enough hype. That scenario obviously does not bode well for the overall market. It would be good for the overall market health and longevity of the CSGO market if Christmas time and the Chinese New Year were able to drive an uptick. Needless to say, there's a lot of uncertainty right now. My plan is to wait till Christmas time, see what happens, and then go from there, because hopefully that event will give us a decent idea of how things are going to go for the future. This is also what I would recommend to you, and maybe for the Christmas time, just try to flip a couple liquids like a few AK Redlines. For those of you deciding to do something completely different and buy into the Stockholm sticker sale, I wish you the best of luck, but I honestly don't think that's going to be a good idea. As for the Chinese New Year, you kind of have two different paths. The first is buying generic high-tier items like Howls, Fire Serpents, Glock Fades, stuff like that. The second path is buying Operation skins, specifically from Broken Fang and from Operation Riptide. Either one of those paths is going to be a decent idea. You could also buy from Shattered Web, but I think the margins on Broken Fang and Riptide are going to be better. As you can probably tell, Chinese New Year is going to be an extremely expensive one, and that's really only for the very high-tier investors that are really only looking to flip for that event. Moving on to the event after that, the summertime, you're going to be looking at mid-year tournament stickers and liquids as well. By mid-year tournament stickers, I mean anything from like 2015 up to like 2018.
those years all had really solid stickers that tend to do really good during this time. Obviously stuff like Kato 15 and Kludge Napoca are going to be different, but generally speaking, stickers that fall into that range of years are the ones that perform the best. Now if you're not looking to wait for one of these events, your best bet's probably going to be with cases, honestly. Generally speaking, every time there's a decent sized update in CSGO, a case or a couple cases get moved into the rare drop pool. This almost always makes the price of the case go really high, and for case investors, there's usually a lot of money to be made here. This all depends on finding the best case, but generally the information is always going to be the same with cases in terms of their quantity and their volume. I already have guides on investing in cases though, so if you want to go ahead and learn more about that, you can always look at those. Like I mentioned, the benefit to cases is that you don't really have to wait for one of these events to happen, but you are going to be relying on CSGO updates. If you're brand new to the topic of cases, another good resource is CSGO Database's page on cases. They're going to have all the information that you could possibly need on cases in each pool, so if you want to check them out, use the link. And with all of that, you should really be up to speed on what your next move might be in the world of CSGO investing going forward into these next few months and into the summer. It's hard to say when the CSGO market's gonna pick back up, but the game is certainly not dead, and there is definitely a lot of interest in the market. It's just not really enough hype to push things forward. I'm not gonna drag this out, but one quick recap. If you want to go ahead and invest in this Christmas time, your best bet's probably going to be liquid items like AK Redlines, AWP Asimovs, Deagle Print Streams potentially. Those are all good options. If you're aiming for the Chinese New Year, your best options are going to be with high tier items and maybe even some of these new operation skins, especially the pinks and reds. And if you're aiming for the summer, once again, liquids are going to be a pretty good idea, and tournament stickers ranging from the years 2015 to about 2018. And with that, that's about all I have for you guys today, so thanks for watching the video. On the IRL side of things, I got moved into a new place, and so once I get Wi-Fi set up, I should be able to keep producing content like I was a few months back, so be sure to check out my channel. If you want notifications for all that content, just be sure to go ahead and click the subscribe button for the best CSGO investment tips anywhere else on YouTube. You can also check out my Discord and Twitter using the links in the description below. And of course, you can always check out ShadowPay using the link in the description below if you want to go ahead and get some cheap CSGO skins, way cheaper than the Steam community market, and a deposit bonus if you use my link. Thanks guys, see you next time. Peace.